Now, let us compare different AC circuit elements. We have discussed about three different circuit components, resistance, capacitance, and an inductor. Now, if an alternating current I flows through the three circuit components, we can directly state in case of resistance, the potential difference across the terminals A and B, we can write as IR. And here we can write the value of R as a constant. And in case of resistance, we can also write that VAB is in same phase with I. And if we talk about capacitor, we know that if a current I flows through it, the potential difference across the terminals of capacitor, we can write I multiplied by XC. Here I am directly using Ohm's law, where XC is the ohmic opposition of capacitor across the AC terminals if a current, alternating current flows through it. Here the value of XC we can write as 1 by omega C. And in case of capacitor, we know well that the potential difference across a capacitor lags behind the current by a phase angle pi by 2. So we can write VAB lags behind I by phi is equals to pi by 2. Similarly, in case of inductor, the potential difference across inductor we can write as IXL, where the value of XL we write as omega L ohms. And we already studied that potential difference across an inductor leads current by phase angle pi by 2. Now here you can see the value of resistance always remain constant, but the value of reactance, whether it is capacitive or inductive, it depends on the value of omega, which is the angular frequency of AC source. This is the angular frequency of AC source, this is the frequency at which the alternating current is being generated. If we just plot a variation curve of various parameters, ohmic values versus frequency. So in this situation here we can see, if we plot it with the frequency or omega, where omega is equals to 2 pi f, the difference is omega we are measuring in radian per second and f we are measuring in hertz. Now if this plotted for R and X, here we can see the value of R remains constant, it does not change with frequency. But if we talk about XL, it is written as omega L, it is proportionately changing with the angular frequency, so it must be a straight line which gives XL is equals to omega L. Here the value of inductance is a constant. Similarly, if we talk about the capacitive reactance, it is falling with the angular frequency, or it will be a curve like a rectangular hyperbola like this, where we can see here XC is given as 1 by omega C. So with frequency we can see the capacitive reactance decreases and inductive reactance proportionately increases. So you must be careful about how with frequency these circuit parameters are changing, because this plays a very important role in analyzing different kind of circuits. We'll also analyze the behavior of capacitive and inductive reactance at very low and high frequency in the next section.